Alright, so yeah, if you like to take some macro photos of all kind of stuff like some leaves for example, you probably wonder how to get these nice crispy results. And exactly that's why I've collected a few tips and tricks that you can use to improve your own results. So let's get straight into today's video with tip number one, and in this case we need to talk about your lens. You've probably already heard it, but in my opinion this is one of the most fundamental things that makes it possible to get these stunning results, and here I'm talking about a macro lens. And yeah, there are a lot of lenses out there, but a few of them actually have a macro feature, and this allows us to get way closer to our key element and still get the focus on point. And that is extremely important for macro photography, because if you try to get close to your object and your camera simply can't set the focus, the overall image will be blurry. So if you want to improve your macro photography, I highly recommend to buy a good macro lens that makes it way easier for you to take these images. I personally love to use the Canon RF 35mm 1.8 macro because I absolutely love the 35mm look and I can get really close to my key element. On top, this lens isn't that expensive, you can get one for around 500 bucks, so that's absolutely worth it. But of course you don't have to buy a new lens just to improve your macro photography. In most cases another big mistake is the shallow depth of field. Don't get me wrong here, I absolutely love the shallow depth of field that you can get with a 2.8 or 1.8 aperture, but it doesn't matter if your key element isn't in focus. Especially if you like to take macro photos, only a small part of your key element will be in focus if you want to have such a shallow depth of field. So if you want to have all these details in focus, you need to stop down and use a larger f-stop number to get more and more in focus. And this totally depends on your photo idea and on your key element. So what I can highly recommend is to set up your camera and take a couple of test shots. Next, simply go into the preview and zoom in to see if your focus and the shallow depth of field is good or if you have to change some settings. I personally do this all the time to double check my settings and photos just to see if everything is fine or if I have to take another photo with some different settings. But now let's move on with the next tip that I can give you, and this one is all about stabilization, and there are a couple of ways that you can use to improve your results. And the first one is all about handheld macro photography. If you take your macro photos handheld, and I do that most of the time, I highly recommend to switch on all kind of options for stabilization. So as an example, if your lens has such a switch here, just turn it on. This feature makes it easier for you to get steady shots even though if you take photos handheld, and most lenses have such a switch. So definitely double check that and use the lens IS to get better results. The second option that you can use is IBIS. And yeah, not every camera uses this feature, but if you can use it, use it. Especially in combination with the lens IS, it is way easier to get good results, so don't waste this opportunity to make your overall workflow way faster and easier. The third option is the digital IS. A few cameras who don't have this IBIS feature offers the digital IS. So what happens is that the camera crops in a little bit to create some headroom, and this can be used to reduce the shakiness. So even if you can't use IBIS, I can still recommend to use this instead, even though it creates this crop factor in your images. But now let's move on to the fourth option, and here we need to talk about tripods. A tripod is the best solution to get steady shots because your camera isn't moving around. So if you don't have any other options to stabilize your camera, just use the tripod, which can actually improve your results a lot. I mostly use the tripod especially if I need to take pictures at home, so I can simply move it around and build a set that fits the frame. So I highly recommend to have a tripod if you'd like to take macro photos. But one of the best tips that I can give you is to give this video a thumbs up and smash that subscribe button, because the algorithm likes it and it would help me to grow this channel. But yeah, now let's talk about the next tip, and this one is extremely important if you take photos handheld, and here we need to talk about the shutter speed. What I notice is that most people just check their ISO and aperture settings, but especially the shutter speed is extremely important. Because if you want to take a photo of something that is moving around and your shutter speed isn't fast enough, the overall image will be blurry because of that movement. And yet you always have a tiny movement in your frame if you take photos handheld, and exactly that's why I mostly care about a fast shutter speed to avoid this problem. So yeah, definitely keep that in your mind to use a fast shutter speed when you're out there taking photos handheld. Another quick tip to take some better macro photos handheld is to use the continuous shooting mode. If you use such a mode, you can simply press and hold the shutter button and your camera will take a lot of photos without pressing the shutter button again. And in some cases can be really helpful because you avoid the situation that your camera is moving around because you press the shutter button again. So in the end, the second or third picture will be even better because of the missing camera shake. Or what you can do instead is to use a remote to take your pictures. And yeah, most cameras have an app that you can use to take pictures, so you don't have to buy a special remote to do that. If I want to take pictures remotely with my Canon 80D, EOS R or R5, I can simply use the camera app to take these images. So I never have to touch the camera to adjust all kind of settings or even to take a picture. It is super easy to do, so use these features to get better results. So yeah, question of the day. Do you have any other tips to take better macro photos handheld? Let me know that in the comments. So, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're new here, don't forget to smash that subscribe button to stay updated for upcoming videos, and I'll see you in the next video.